Hi everyone, welcome back. Having discussed in my previous video about how to drag and drop and resize the events in the React scheduler, now in this video, I will show you how to drag and drop the appointments from the external source into the React scheduler. Look at this online example that shows the doctor appointments on the scheduler, and there are few unscheduled appointments that are displayed as a waiting list using the TreeView component. Here, the TreeView component acts as an external source from which I can drag a particular item into the scheduler. You can see here the pop-up is opened when you drop those items onto the scheduler, which allows you to fill any incomplete details before it is being created as an appointment onto the scheduler. Once you are done with filling the details, then click the Save button so that the dropped item will be added as an appointment on the scheduler. Now, let me proceed to show you how to achieve this using the scheduler APIs. First, I'm going to open my existing application where I have added a React scheduler with few normal appointments. To know how to create React scheduler and add appointments to it, please look on to my Getting Started video and you can find its reference link from the description part below. As I said before, I'm going to use the TreeView component as an external source here. So, I need to install EJ2 React Navigations package using the command npm install @Synfusion/EJ2-React-Navigations to add the TreeView component in my application. To start with the example directly, I have already installed the complete navigations package, and therefore, to start using the TreeView component here, I need to import the TreeView component from Synfusion EJ2 React Navigations package, and also I need to define the TreeView component code along with the scheduler component within the render method. Here, to separate the scheduler and TreeView component, I have added a few div sections with class name. Also, I have defined few CSS style for those div sections in app.css file. Now, let me add the data source for the TreeView component to display the unscheduled appointment list and assign this particular array of objects to the data source property of TreeView. Also, I will define the field mapping names for this data source. Then, I need to assign this variable field to the fields property of the TreeView component. Now, when you look at the output page, you can find the TreeView component rendered beside the scheduler. So, I will proceed to show you the code snippet for enabling the drag action on TreeView component and how to save those dragged items from the TreeView component onto the scheduler. First, I need to enable the drag and drop action on TreeView component by setting the property allow drag and drop as true. And now, I can drag an item from the TreeView component, but I cannot drop them onto the scheduler as I need to write the code for handling this scenario. So now, I will define the client-side event of TreeView noDragStop, which triggers when an item from the TreeView component is dragged and dropped onto the target area. Within this event, I'm going to write the code for saving the dropped data onto the scheduler. So, I have defined the onTreeDragStop method, which accepts the argument of type drag and drop event args, and to access this drag and drop event args, I need to import it from Synfusion EJ2 React Navigations. Before I save the dragged item on the scheduler, I should know the time range value on the scheduler where the item is currently being dropped. For example, when I drag an item from the TreeView component and drop it over the scheduler cells, I should know the target cells time details. So, to get the time details of the underlying cells of scheduler, I need to make use of the scheduler's method getCellDetails, which accepts the argument of target HTML element. So here, I will pass the target cell element of the scheduler. Now, let me show you how to access this public method getCellDetails of scheduler. To access any such public methods or properties of scheduler, first I need to access the scheduler component instance inside the React component. For this purpose, I need to add a reference to the scheduler component code and define its instance here. After adding such reference, now you can access them using this schedule object.getCellsDetail. And here, I have passed HTML element, which is the scheduler's target cell element. Now, you can see here that I have assigned this getCellDetails method to the cell data variable, which is of the type cellClickEventTags. To access the cellClickEventTags type, I need to import it from Synfusion EJ2 React Schedule package first. Now, let me tell you what this method getCellDetails will retrieve. It will return the start time, end time, all day information, and the other resource related information of the target cell. Here, I have retrieved the cell details, and using it, I have formed the appointment object and assigned it to a variable. And finally, using the addEvent method of scheduler, I will pass this appointment object as argument to it and save the dropped item onto the scheduler. And now, when I drag an item from the TreeView component and drop it onto the scheduler, you can see that particular item getting added onto the exact time range where I have dropped it. You can also set the built-in editor window to open before saving this appointment to the scheduler by making a call to the OpenEditor method of scheduler instead of addEvent. In this case, the appointment object formed from the retrieved cell details should be passed as an argument to the OpenEditor method and the addEvent method line should be commented. Now, when I drag and drop an item from the TreeView component into the scheduler, the built-in editor window gets opened and prompting you to add furthermore details. And when you click Save button on the editor window, the appointment will get added to the scheduler. So that's all about how to drag and drop an event from the external source into the scheduler component. To summarize what we have learned in this video, we have seen how to add TreeView component to the existing React application, and also how to drag and drop an item from the external TreeView component into the React scheduler. Finally, we have also seen how to open the editor window before adding the dropped event as an appointment to the scheduler. If you find this video as useful, then click the like button and subscribe to our channel too. Thank you once again for watching this video.